Archdiocese says St. Peter Claver School is $7 million in debt and unable to continue serving its 196 low-income students.
KETV News Watch 7's Michelle Bandour has more in the big story at 6, and she is live near 36th and Q.
Christy, the Archdiocese says it simply ran out of options and money to keep Cristo Rey open, but educators hope that the mission will live on through the students who have already walked through the hallways. It's a hard lesson for any student.
I just felt bad for the juniors.
But for Cristo Rey students and parents, many who are struggling, the news of shutting down the school is even more difficult.
It's sad. Like, this is a great school, and for them to close is just unfortunate. I really wanted my other kids to come here.
I wouldn't have reached so far to accomplish something so big.
Cristo Rey opened in 2007 on borrowed money. Businesses helped pay tuition by giving students jobs. The kids go to school 4 days and work one day. But the economy forced many businesses to lay off the students, and that means no tuition.
In the climate we're all familiar with, the economic realities, it just... we couldn't just get over that hump.
This setback will make the determined students even stronger, says Deacon Tim McNeil.
You have already shown the world that you can do it. And now, whether it's at this school or at another school, you've achieved that. And so I think that's the legacy of Cristo Rey to these students.
Senior Scott Licote proudly wears the last 2011 letter jacket for the first and last graduating class. He's honored to be part of this special school.
It's a bittersweet moment. I was looking forward to coming back after I graduated and showing everybody how I did and kind of an inspiration to other students, and now that it's closed down, it's like, aw.
Faculty and staff will also lose their jobs, 24 full-time staffers and 3 part-times when the school closes for good in June. Some of the underclassmen, though, the Archdiocese hopes to transfer them to other Catholic schools here. Reporting live, Michelle Bandour, KETV, Newswatch 7.